So you're advocating a change, just vary things a little. Yeah. Ministry in Motion, it's a global program, mm-hmm. and we have pastors all over the world yes. watching this. Mm-hmm. So it's hard to advocate a specific resource right. or place that people can go.
Right.
But what should, if a pastor is in that dark place, what would you advise that they do? Make some sort of a change. But you would encourage a pastor, nothing is so dark, so bad, that you need to terminate your life. That there is help.
Yeah.
And there is help within every community, whether it's friendships, whether it's connecting, whether it's confessing.
Right.
Talk to us about that and those options. Mm-hmm.
So part of my background is as a marriage and family therapist as well, and yet I have been in therapy too, which is to say it's not only for people who are crazy, it's actually for healthy people that are going through a difficult time in life. And so one of the things that we encourage you is to find that kind of help. Some conferences produce or provide, I should say, a contact, whether it be a chain or a specific counselor. Seek a counselor that you feel comfortable with and talk to, because sometimes just processing through it helps you to clear the darkness that you're going through. Friendships, and sometimes you have to develop friendships outside of the church, maybe pastors of a different denomination, or in fact just simply friends. That's why sometimes going to sporting activities with people who are not of your church and develop those relationships mm-hmm. can become another outlet for those times when you're going through the valleys of the depression or whatever it may be.
And I would also caution or tell spouses or friends or other colleagues, if you notice this in an individual, speak up.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to confront them and say, hey, friend, you know, I'm noticing something, and encourage them to get the help that they need.
So what are some of the specific danger signals would you be looking for that a person could do with a little, you know, special attention?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Well, for instance, changes in their habits, normal habits. They're eating too much or not eating enough. They're sleeping too much or not sleeping enough. Their moodiness, maybe they get very angry very quickly or very depressed very quickly, very sad very quickly. So those drastic changes are something that you can for sure know something is not right. And it's not a sin to say, is everything okay with you?
Yeah.
What are you going through? Let's talk through this right now. So those outside signs, if they are very obvious, don't ignore them at all.
Isolation, you know, withdrawal.
Yeah.
You know, I'm pulling myself away from my family. I'm locking myself more in my study. I'm not going to as many social events. Mm. So pulling away from those things.
Mm. So watching... You're describing people here that are in community and the importance yes. of that community mm-hmm. yes. and then responding appropriately.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, in a loving and a generous and a kind way.
Don't ignore the signs.
Right. Yeah.
In fact, even asking the question, have you or are you thinking about taking your life? Some people would think, well, why would you plant that thought in a person's mind? Well, it's been proved that you never plant a thought. If the thought is there, it's already there, and it's better to approach it and deal with it. So it's not a sin, it's not dangerous to say to someone, you know, the way you're talking, the way you're behaving is of concern to me. Are you thinking of harming yourself? That, I think, is more helpful than ignoring it.